Hello friends, in this video we are going to study the selection of winding for the transformer. Now basically depending upon the rating of the transformer, the winding of transformer can be selected. In previous video we have studied the design of the core. Similarly, in this video we are going to study how to select the proper winding as per the rating and the design considerations of the transformer. The value for the number of turns of the primary side can be written as NP is equal to voltage in the primary winding divided by number of turns. NP is equal to voltage in the primary winding divided by volt per turn. Now further modifying this equation, we get therefore NP is equal to VP divided by ET. Let it be equation number 1. Where NP is equal to turns in the primary winding, VP is the voltage of the primary winding and ET is equal to volt per turns. Similarly, we can write the equation for the secondary winding turns as similarly, NS is equal to VS divided by ET. Let it be equation number 2. Where NS is equal to secondary winding turn and VS is equal to secondary winding voltage. Now if we consider the LV winding and HV winding, then the equation for NP and NS can be modified as NLV is equal to VLV divided by ET, where NLV is the turns of the primary winding, that is LV winding. Similarly, VLV is the voltage of the LV winding. Let it be equation number 3. Similarly, we can write the equation for the HV winding as NHV is equal to VHV divided by ET. Let it be equation number 4. Now basically, the number of turns should always be an integer. If we get the value after solving as the point or in the terms of decimal point, then we have to round it up to make an integer. Now the value for the current in the primary and secondary winding can be written as IP is equal to KVA per phase multiplied by 10 raised to 3 divided by VP. Where IP is the primary winding current and let it be equation number 5. Similarly, equation for the secondary winding current can be written as IS is equal to VP divided by VS multiplied by IP. Let it be equation number 6. Hence, in order to find the value of currents, first we have to find the value of primary current and then by using the value of primary current, we can find the value of secondary current. Now basically the area of the conductor of the primary secondary winding mainly depends upon the value of current density. The permissible current density of the winding should be selected depending upon the value of current. Also, this current density will affect on the losses as well as rise in temperature. So, these points should also be considered while taking in account the current density value. If the higher value of current density is chosen, then the temperature rise in the winding will also be very high. Also, the higher value of current density may lead to the damage to the insulation of the windings. Also, the choice of current density is important because the I2R losses depend upon the value of current density. Now, as the losses for the different transformers are different, so the values for the current density selected for a particular transformer will vary from one transformer to another transformer. For the distribution type of transformer whose rating is up to 50 kVA, the value of current density is in the range of 1.1 to 2.3 ampere per mm square. For large type of transformers, the value of current density is between the range of 2.2 to 3.3 ampere per mm square. Then for large transformers with water cooling, the value of current density is between the range of 5.4 to 6.2 ampere per mm square. Now the area of conductor in the primary winding can be given by AP is equal to IP divided by del P. Similarly, the area of conductor of the secondary winding is given by AS is equal to IS divided by del S. Where AP is the area of conductor in the primary winding, IP is the current in the primary winding, del P is the current density in the primary winding, del S is the current density in the secondary winding, IS is the current in the secondary winding, AS is the area of conductor in the secondary winding. UP is the volume of conductor in the primary winding, US is the volume of conductor in the secondary winding, and UT is the total volume of the conductor. Hence, the equation for the total volume of the conductor can be written as UT is equal to UP plus US. Now, the formula for the I square loss in the primary and secondary winding can be written as So, the I square R loss in the primary winding is given by rho del P square into UP. Similarly, I square R loss in the secondary winding is given by rho del S square into US. Now, UT is equal to UP plus US. Hence, from this equation, the formula for US can be written as US is equal to UT minus UP. Hence, substituting this value in above equation, we get I square R loss in the secondary winding is equal to rho del S square bracket UT minus US. Now the total value of the I square R loss, that is the copper loss, will be the addition of copper loss in the primary winding and the addition of the copper loss in the secondary winding. Hence the total value of the copper loss can be found as therefore, PC is equal to I square R loss in the primary winding plus I square R loss in the secondary winding. Substituting the values of I square loss, which we have already calculated in this equation, we get PC is equal to rho del P square UP plus rho del S square bracket UT minus UP. Now, differentiating this equation with respect to UT, we get dPC by dUP is equal to d by dup of bracket rho del p square up plus rho del s square bracket ut minus up. Now taking the rho outside the equation, we get dpc by dup is equal to rho inside the bracket d by dup multiplied by del p square up plus del s square bracket ut minus up. Further solving this equation, we get dpc by dup is equal to rho inside the bracket d by dup of del p square up plus d by dup of del s square ut minus d by dup of del s square up. After solving this equation, we get dpc by dup is equal to rho inside the bracket del p square, that is the derivative of this term, that is d by dup of del p square up. Up with respect to up will be 1. The constant is del p square. Hence the answer is del p square. Plus in the next term, both del s square and ut are the constants. And the derivative of constant is 0. So the next term is 0. Again, the last term derivative is minus del s square. Hence after solving the equation, we get dpc by dup is equal to rho inside the bracket del p square plus 0 minus del s square. After further solving this equation, we get dpc by dup is equal to rho del p square minus rho del s square. Now, equating above equation to 0, we get dpc by dup is equal to 0. Hence, we can write rho del p square minus rho del s square is equal to 0. Now, taking the term rho del s square on that side of equation, we get rho del p square is equal to rho del s square. Now rho on both side of equation will get cancelled. Hence we can write del p square is equal to del s square. Now taking the square root on both side of equation, we get del p is equal to del s. Hence from this equation we can say that in order to obtain the minimum I square R loss, the current densities of both the winding, that is primary winding as well as secondary winding, should be equal. In practice, however, the current density of outer winding is made 5% extra than the current density of inner winding. Now let us see the selection of type of winding. The winding is such selected that it should attain whatever the desirable electrical characteristics as well as mechanical characteristics. Sometimes more than one type of winding can be used in the transformer. Mostly, the winding which has a simple constructional feature should be used in the transformer. Now, let us see what are the types of high voltage windings. First is cylindrical winding with circular conductors. Second is crossover winding with either circular or small rectangular conductors. And third is continuous disc type winding with the rectangular conductors. The cylindrical and crossover windings are used for the transformers with the rating of 1000 kVA and 33 kilovolts. The disc type winding is used for the transformers ranging from 200 kVA to the turns of MVA and the voltage rating of 11 kV and onwards. The low type of windings are basically of following types. First is cylindrical windings. Second, helical windings. Now both of these windings are using the rectangular type of conductors. Now the cylindrical windings are used for the kVA ratings of up to the 800 kVA, whereas the voltage rating of 433 volts. The helical type of winding is used for the transformer of rating up to 10s of MVA and the voltage rating from 15 kVA up to sometimes 33 kV. Sandwich types of windings are also used in case of shell type transformers. Here there is a table which is showing the ranges of different winding types. Now let us see it in detail. If you consider cylindrical winding having circular conductors, then the kVA rating for this type of winding is from 5000 to 10,000 kVA. The voltage rating is up to 33 kV. Then the maximum conductor is up to 80 ampere. Then conductor cross section is up to 30 mm square. And the total number of parallel conductors are 1 or 2. Then if we see the cylindrical winding having rectangular conductors, then the kVA rating of transformer is from 5000 kVA to 8000 kVA. The voltage rating is up to 6 kV. Mostly it is 0.433 kV, that is 433 volts. Then the maximum current per conductor is from 10 to 600 amperes. Then the conductor cross section is from 5 to 200 mm square. Then the total number of parallel conductors are 1 to 4. If we consider crossover winding, then the kVA rating is up to 1000 kVA. Voltage rating is up to 33 kV. Then the maximum current per conductor is up to 40 ampere. Then the conductor cross-sectional area is up to 15 mm square. Then total number of parallel conductors are 1. Now if you consider helical winding, then it is divided in two sections as per the rating of transformer. Now for up to 160 to tens of the thousands, the voltage rating is up to 15 kV, but mostly it can also go up to 33 kV. Similarly, the current per conductor is 300 amperes and above. The conductor cross section is from 75 to 100 mm square. And total number of conductors connected in parallel are 4 to 6. Next is continuous disc type. The kVA rating for this type of winding is from 200 kVA up to tens of thousands of kVA. Then the voltage rating is from 3.3 kV to 220 kV. Then the current per conductor is 12 ampere and above. Then conductor cross-sectional area is from 4 mm square to 200 mm square. And number of parallel conductors are from 1 to 4. Now let us see the position of windings relative to the core. Basically, there are two types of winding, LV winding and HV winding. Out of these two types of winding, the LV winding is placed for the inner side, that is nearer to the core, whereas HV winding is placed on the outside. The same is shown in the figure. This is the core of our transformer. Then these are the two windings. If we see carefully, the LV insulation is placed on the core. On top of the LV insulation, LV winding is placed. Then HV winding is placed above the LV winding. Generally, this type of arrangement is made because the potential difference between the LV winding and core and the earth is very small. Hence, the occurrence of fault in the LV winding is much less. However, when the HV winding is placed on the outside, then there must be thick insulation between HV winding and LV winding. But due to this, the LMT, that is the length mean term of the conductors, increases. Also, the cost of insulation is high because the HV winding is placed on the outer side on the LV winding. So there must be thick layer of insulation between the HV winding and LV winding. As a result, the cost of insulation will increase. Also, the tappings are provided on the HV winding. So, in this way, depending upon the losses and the current density, the proper windings can be selected. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and do subscribe our channel Ekeeda. Thank you.